say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home?
That incredible performance was from Skylar Cole singing our national anthem. Welcome, everyone. Let's get ready for some NBA basketball on 2K Sports. Our game tonight featuring the Chicago Bulls as they go up against the Boston Celtics. Alongside Greg Anthony and Steve Smith with David Aldridge on the sideline, this is Kevin Harlan. Hey, Dave.
Thanks very much, Kevin. Nikola Vucevic has a new role on the Bulls. He said, in Orlando, everything was going through me. Now there are more guys who can score, so I try to do other things to help the team, like passing and rebounding and screening. When you have so much talent around you, you have to adjust. There are many ways you can impact the game. Kevin, you are impacting this broadcast. Back to you.
You are too, DA. Thank you so much. And now the opening lineup for Boston. Out on the wings, it's Brown and Tatum. Williams is out there with Horford, and it's Smart in at point. And for Chicago, LaVine and DeRozan, the lethal wing pair. Williams and Vucevic hold down the post for him. And it's Dosunmu in at the point.
How about the job Billy Donovan has done? Under 500 in his first season, but took the Bulls to the playoffs in his second year at the helm.
Here we go.
And the Bulls start out with the ball. DeRozan with it. To the middle. Here's Williams. Boston grabs the miss. They defeated the Pelicans in their last game.
Yeah, their long-range artillery hit the mark more often than not. A great equalizer when you're on the road.
They embrace the challenge as well. They hit big shot after big shot to keep the other team at bay.
Lots of pieces have been added to this Bulls roster. For Donovan, you were just talking about him, to work with, coach, and lead. He has done a good job.
They have a great mix, Kevin, of veteran leadership and young talent. Donovan has been able to mix and match to keep guys fresh. It worked well for him in the playoffs last year. Just couldn't find an answer for Giannis and the Bucks.
And there it is for him.
And love how assured Brown looks taking these shots. His mid-range game is on point. He's squaring up like that.
Now, here's DeRozan. He's a guy that can score, no doubt, averaging over 25 points a game. Williams, a screen on Brown. Here's LaVine. And again, no good by Chicago. Here's the Celtics with the ball. Their last encounter was in Boston.
And that last one came right down to the wire. The difference for me being the impact they got from their bench.
Having that spark off the bench really helped them the last time these two teams battled. We'll see if it'll be there for them again.
Here's LaVine. Not a good performance from him in that loss to Orlando. Pass to Williams. Vucevic setting the pick for Williams. And stolen by Horford. Brown feeling it out a bit. Horford finds Brown. Outside Williams. just 5 on the clock. Boston needs to get off a shot. There's Brown with the 3. Can't hit that one. And the Bulls going the other way now. DeRozan in the corner. He dishes it to LaVine. Out to DeRozan. Williams has a screen for DeRozan. He's now 1-for-2 with that bucket.
That's his bread and butter. DeRozan has made a living with the mid-range jumper.
Brown, the pass to Smart. First quarter of play. We're about 3 minutes in. Tatum against DeRozan. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Last game matched up with the Magic. A tough loss there.
I mean, in the modern era, you have to be able to stretch the floor or you're going to struggle.
Reason why, that opens up driving lanes, makes it dangerous for teams to double you in the post. The offense becomes more dynamic.
Here's Tatum. The Bulls getting their last shot to go. Horford kicks to Tatum. There's Brown with the 3. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. Brown's got 8 points. With so much of the season still in front of us, Smitty, what does the main focus have to be for a team on any given night?
Well, winning's never a bad idea, Kevin. These games mean just as much now as they do in April. You can work on rotations and chemistry, but don't let it cost you wins.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
The pass to Horford. And he banks in the layup.
And folks, this is Horford in his zone. Wasn't going to let that opportunity slip away.
Tatum against DeRozan. Vucevic a screen on Brown. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. Steve, it's been tremendous to see Zach LaVine reach his all-star potential in recent years.
Kevin, you can tell he's loving it too, right? But yeah, this was a long time coming. He's at the top of his game, earning his spot among the best players in this league, Kevin.
And he knocks down the first one.
Kevin, what's so impressive to me about LaVine? It's the all-around play. He affects the game across the board.
Javonte Green, he's checked in for Williams. The Celtics also changing it up. Malcolm Brogdon comes in for Williams. And it's wide in for Marcus Smart. And so LaVine nails both of them. And LaVine's efficient as well.
And good shooting numbers, no doubt. Last year, he cut back on the turnovers. And boy, he's still young. There's still tons of upside to be had.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the 3. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Now, here's Dosunmu. He's coming off a 13-point game against Orlando.
His shot blocking dominated the game. His 3 blocks really had an effect on defense.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing.
And it also shows you how difficult this game is. He's just a little bit off, but it can result in missing everything.
And there's the call on Malcolm Brogdon. That's his first foul. So for the Bulls, Bradley's checked in for DeRozan. Alex Crusoe comes in for LaVine, and it's Dragic in for Dosunmu. Boston also with the sub. Blake Griffin, he's checked in for Tatum. Now here's Dragic. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. Vucevic setting the pick for Dragic. And it's Bradley. That time on the assist from Dragic.
Good setup by Gorn. Keeps himself under control, makes the right decision.
And here's Brown. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. Passes it to Horford. Back to Brown. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And one thing that stands out about this Celtics unit, their defensive abilities. They've got a lot of skill on that end of the floor.
Boston shooting their initial free throws of the game right here.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
No good on that one. You're right. Defense, it's been terrific for him. This Boston team, GA, certainly has a talent for holding back their opponent's shots and really defending well.
And, Kevin, they put a lot of energy into pressuring shooters, making sure guys can't find easy looks. They don't want to give away anything for free.
And he sinks the second.
And the vertical that Brown has is pretty impressive, as relentless a finisher as you'll find in our league.
Dragic finds Caruso. Back to Dragic. Let's the three fly. They get it back. Here's Drummond. Pass to Caruso. Outside Brantley. Shot clock at five. From deep three-point range, White with the defensive effort.
And when you are as good a shooter as he is, you have to have the confidence to take that shot. It might not always fall.
You know what another option is? Just give the ball up. Let someone else make a play.
Outside, Dragic takes a three. Rebounded by the Celtics. And here is Brogdon. No points in the game yet for him. Horford with a screen on Caruso. And it's Dragic with the foul. That's his first foul. .109 left in the first. Horford with a screen on Dragic. White the pass to Horford. Softly drops in the floater. And the Celtics lead by five.
Beautiful find by Derek White. When you start your career with Coach Popovich, you either make the next pass or you don't get minutes.
Now here's Dragic. He's looking for Drummond and finds him. Goes up and lays it nice and easy.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
So it's Boston now. White looking around. Brown outside. Goran Dragic grabs the board. Well, Chicago has gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Bradley sets the pick for Caruso. Five on the clock. Good D by Brogdon.
This is the shot you want, right at the rim. He just couldn't deliver.
Here's Brown, and then Brown with the dunk.
A primary responsibility of Brogdon's. When someone is open on his squad, he gets it to him.
Jaylen Brown has been leading the charge for the Boston Celtics. He comes away with 11 points in the quarter and is showing no signs of fatigue. And we've got more M2K Sports coming your way after this break. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. And the Celtics guys, what jumps out to you stats-wise?
Stingy on the defensive end in that first quarter. They were just getting up into people.
Yeah, they were very physical and very aggressive. They've just been the better team so far.
Boston leading by five. The wing set for him, LaVine and DeRozan. Williams and Vucevic hold down the post for him. And it's Dosunmu in at the point guard. That's the Bulls five as we get into the second quarter. And here are the Bulls now. After Jason Tatum missed on that last three-pointer. On the wing, DeRozan. Guarded by Tatum. And he makes that one.
One of the biggest progressions for DeMar DeRozan. Now can create his shot off the dribble in a variety of ways.
And that was the Mobile One Drive. well worth a second look.
And putting that pressure on the rim, that's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
Now here's Griffin, still looking for his first bucket in this one. No coverage that time. Williams has got the lead up to six now for the Celtics. The Bulls shooting just 33%, struggling to get good looks. And around a minute gone here in the second quarter. And there's the bucket from Dosunmu.
Nice job getting inside for the layup. Got the D thinking. Jump shot, gave a little pump fake, and then off to the races.
Pritchard passes to Griffin. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
You know, it's not just the power of Griffin, it's the skill set. Reliable inside.
Pass to Levine. And Zach LaVine gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game.
And really just a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Boston Celtics. They lead by six, their biggest margin. A three ball. Vucevic with the rebound. Vucevic has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. LaVine dishes to Williams. And that comes off the assist by LaVine.
A tough start scoring the basketball, but they're starting to turn it around now.
Tatum kicks to Williams. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. You know, Greg, you played on some gritty teams, and we hear that expression, getting punched in the mouth, and it's not usually literal. But what's that look like on the floor? What's it feel like on the court?
Kevin, you're just out hustling and out muscling the team. At times, you'll see it. They've kind of checked out mentally, and I'll tell you what, it is one of the best feelings in sport.
And that one falls for Williams. And good on the second, so he makes them both.
And what makes Chicago tricky to defend, Kevin, they just have such a balanced attack. They can score in the paint from mid-range or hurt you from deep.
Now, here's Dosunmu. And they get some nice contributions from him on a nightly basis as he averages over 11 points a game. Here's LaVine. 6-point game. Right side, Griffin. Outside, Williams. Celtics passing it around. Tatum finds Griffin. Six to shoot. Back to Tatum. The three. Again, the miss by the Celtics. You know, as the Bulls have become a more veteran team, Greg, it feels like they've settled into what they do well.
And you need a strong identity to be successful in this league. Chicago is building towards that, but it does take time.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for Boston.
They're unselfish. They're passing the ball well, setting up teammates, playing team basketball, and their focus.
And we also have seen them continue to fire from deep. With the results they're seeing, you can understand why.
You know, Greg, some guys are late bloomers, but DeRozan, he was just the opposite.
Yeah, reports are he had handles at age 3. First dunk came in the 6th grade, 5-star high school prospect, and in a strange way, he's still an underrated superstar.
Bucket is good. Now just a 1-point Celtic lead.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Boston's gone 1-of-4 from 3-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played.
Smart against Williams. Williams with the block.
That's what they want from Patrick. Active, aggressive, in-your-face defense.
And there's the pass to Vucevic. The dish to Levine. Vucevic setting the pick for Levine. Back to Vucevic. Bulls with the fresh shot clock. Levine's shot is off. For Boston, they've gone 2-6 in the field in the second quarter so far. The feed to Griffin. Great D that time from Vucevic. For Chicago, they've gone 5-7 from the field here in the second. And the rejection by Tatum.
And how about the craftiness from Tatum? He plays smart, quick hands on defense, and able to block the shot.
Now here's Griffin. Williams with the block. And he gets it back. Count it. Now here's Dosunmu. Passes it to DeRozan. Vucevic, a screen on Tatum. DeRozan passes to Vucevic. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's going to be on Blake Griffin.
You got to love what he brings to the table. Nikola Vucevic, not too shabby from the line either. He can shoot it.
Free throw drops for Vucevic.
What you love about Vucevic, the consistency, solid shooting percentages, and he's averaged double-digit rebounds for the last 5 years.
Catching up now on the changes for Chicago. Drummond's checked in for Patrick Williams. Javonte Green comes in for DeMar DeRozan. Alex Caruso, he's checked in for Levine, and it's Dragic in for Dosunmu. That's also good, so he hits both free throws. You know, Greg, adding to that for Vucevic, the last two seasons, he's been excellent in the playoffs.
Great point, Kevin. His numbers were up over what he did in the regular season. He hits clutch shots, gives them a physical presence, and he is just a rock in the middle.
The Celtics have gone 3-4 at the free throw line tonight.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
Shooting two.
Free throw drops for Al Horford. Chicago making a switch here. Bradley's checked in. So Horford gets two.
He's living there tonight, a tough guy to guard without fouling. And the bonus, he's going to knock him down.
Now Dragic, nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Drummond with a screen on Brogdon. Here's Caruso, banked in off the glass.
That's all focused by Alex Caruso, absorbing the contact and getting the finish.
And here's White. He'll bring it up for Boston. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot. Bulls trail by 3. Dragic with it. Drummond with a screen on White. Dragic dishes to Drummond. Here's Caruso. They get the rebound. And that one's good. Drummond.
What makes Drummond a great rebounder? Not just the size and athleticism. It's his tremendous anticipation.
Now here's Brown. He picked up 27 points in their last win against the Pelicans in New Orleans.
And what opened things up for him was his passing. He was making so many plays that the D had to play off it.
1:53 left in the first half. Dragic the pass to Caruso. Inside and stolen by Horford. To the paint. Here's Tatum. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Caruso gets the Dragic. Back to Caruso. Dishes to Green. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Six on the shot clock. There's Dragic with the three, and they recover it. Second chance shot. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points, so one free throw coming up.
One of the top two or three rebounders in the game, Drummond makes his presence felt.
Chicago shooting their sixth attempt at the charity stripe in the game.
Well, now when you foul Drummond, he can hurt you a little bit at the line. He's much improved.
104 left in the second quarter. Brogdon the pass to White. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. Here's the 2K leaderboard. These teams have been fantastic from three-point land in the last 10. Fifth on the list, the Celtics.
The way they space the floor is why they get so many open three-pointers. It's all about how they consistently move around the court.
Tatum wide open. He fires one. And again, Boston with the triple.
And they've done a great job knocking down those long-range shots here in the second, shooting just over 40% from downtown.
Now, here's Caruso. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Drummond sets the screen for Dragic and stolen by Horford. White inside. He's guarded by Dragic. Up and in, off to an efficient start, 2 for 3 from the field.
Unselfish play by Tatum, getting it to a shooter in rhythm instead of chasing his own shot.
Drummond with a screen on White. No good from Dragic.
Not sure why he keeps trying his luck from deep here. It's just not his night.
Here's Tatum. Horford sets a screen for Tatum. And that one released in time, but no good. And we've reached halftime in this one. Celtics lead by 6. 30. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Booch. They had it going the first two quarters. How do you turn that around defensively?
Just got to get one-on-one stops, do a better job helping each other, just, you know, getting whatever they want on that end, and we have to do a better job. And, it's just simple, you know, one-on-one stops. When we help, make sure the guy that helps, he gets help, and just keep rotating. We haven't done a good job with that. We're usually very good with that. So just got to, you know, focus, you know, and come back in the second half ready. Then we can make it a game if we play better defensively.
Thanks for your time, man. Appreciate it. Back to you guys.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
Thanks for joining us through the first half. There is still some work to do for the Chicago Bulls.
Where's the game plan? Seems like they're making things up as they go along, like Kenny.
I think we're all too guilty of that at times. Not always easy to stay on script.
Exactly.
Changing things up now, let's take a glance at the upcoming schedule.
And for their matchup with the Mavericks, they should be considered the favorites in that one. But they can't afford to take their foot off the pedal. That's when they get in trouble.
Don't want to fall into a trap game.
Thanks for joining us. Now let's toss it to Kevin Harlan for the start of the second half.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. It's been a clinic out there by Jaylen Brown.
Yeah, and just look at the numbers from the first half. He has been very efficient.
And it's not like everything's been at the rim. There's been a number of jump shots along the way.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. On the court right now for the Celtics, Tatum and Williams up in the forward spots. Smart in the backcourt with Brown to his side. And it's Horford in at the five. Tatum's shot is off. And here's LaVine, who brings it up for the Chicago Bulls. They trail by six. Vucevic, a screen on Tatum. And DeRozan kicks to Williams. Clock at six. To the inside, Vucevic. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Williams. Vucevic has got the first basket of the third quarter for the Bulls. That was a second look at our Mobile One drive. Amazing control on display.
And that's the kind of bucket they needed. Close game in the second half. Great finish on that one.
And here's Smart. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Tatum passes to Brown. Now Smart puts the move on, and he sinks the layup. Smart's got the lead back up to six now for the Celtics.
And this is where Smart's at his best, being aggressive, going towards the rim.
Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. And Marcus Smart, GA, the very definition of a guy you love on your team, but hate to play against.
Yeah, and teams that go deep need that sort of presence. Smart is more than just an agitator, though. Great player who anyone would want to play alongside. And Smitty, in that 21-22 season, DeMar DeRozan proved to be one of the top closers in our game.
You're totally right, GA. He led the NBA in fourth quarter points and finished second in clutch scoring. He embraced the challenge and thrived playing the role of the hero.
That's good from DeRozan.
I mean, a terrific free throw shooter. DeRozan really pushes the action, looking to score and or get fouled.
DeMar DeRozan hits them both. Here's Brown. 11 points in the game. Pass to Smart. 90 seconds now into the second half. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
As tough as they get, Smart's a bulldog out there. Does a good job of drawing contact, oftentimes by initiating it.
This is his first free throw of the game.
And from the line thus far, how about 83% on the season? Outstanding.
And the first one drops.
And some of what Smart gives this team doesn't always show up in the stat sheet, but he makes plays that help you win.
So he gets them both. Bulls trail by six. DeRozan, a screen on Smart. Outside DeRozan. Fires for three. It's no good. He's now 4 of 9 from the field. Brown kicks to Smart. His three-pointers off the mark. And Chicago shooting 43% from the field. Vucevic, a screen on Smart. Brown against DeRozan. Over Brown. And that one hits back iron. Celtics leading by six. Outside Tatum. Outside Williams. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
Only one for four in this half. Sometimes it's execution. Sometimes the shots just don't go down.
Pass to Dosunmu. Good. And it's DeRozan picking up the assists. Dosunmu's got five now.
I love the vision by DeMar DeRozan. He found the wide-open teammate.
The pass to Brown for three. That's another one for him. His fifth in just seven shots.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working.
How often do we see this these days? Clubs answering each other from range.
And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. Pritchard, he's checked in for Jason Tatum. Now a chance to take a look at some numbers for Alex Caruso. Here's Dosunmu. He's got five.
Yeah, the defender all over him.
The Bulls have been a perfect 8 of 8 at the line.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good. Both shots good from the stripe. Boston leading by four. Passes it to Horford. The Celtics working the ball around now. Brown inside the line. The basket is good off the assist from Williams. Williams has got three assists now in this one. Third quarter action and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. Dosunmu, the pass to DeRozan. Shoots over Brown. And it's DeRozan missing.
And he's frustrated. That's a shot he can make in his sleep.
Here's Pritchard. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Brown outside. Shot clock at six. Launches a three. And the Celtics hit again from deep.
So reliable. They've really leaned on him at the offensive end.
Oh, here's Dosunmu. Not a lot of room. Kick out to Levine. Picked by Vucevic. That's it, and the Celtic lead is cut down now to just six in the basket from Levine.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be payback. Levine matching threes and making plays.
Pritchard passes to Brown. Baseline try. Rebounded by Vucevic. Vucevic has got six rebounds now in the game. Al Levine, 5 points in the game. Here's DeRozan, rebounded by Smart.
And for his offense, this has just been a brutal period.
Pritchard passes to Brown, shoots over DeRozan. That one a little long. Bulls trail by six. Step back shot, the rebound by the Celtics. Horford's got his fourth rebound in this one.
I can see he's pressing a little now, trying desperately to help them shrink this deficit.
Pritchard passes to Brown. It's stolen by DeRozan. Over Brown. That doesn't go either for DeRozan.
He has gone ice cold this quarter. Obviously not helping their cause.
Pass to Smart. The shot's good on the assist by Horford. Smart's got six here in this quarter.
For a guy who's still working on his range, love to see Smart attacking on the interior.
And the Bulls call timeout here. So Chicago ends up going with the new group. And then for Boston, Griffin's checked in for Williams. White comes in for Brown. And Malcolm Brogdon subbed in for Pritchard. Here's Dragic. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Down low. And Green slams it in.
A sneaky pick and roll player. Goran Dragic on point. Dishes to the roller.
And so it's Brogdon who brings up the ball for the Celtics. A Smitty one-way, Javonte Green got our attention early on in his career. Was with his spectacular acrobatics, those great dunks.
Kevin, I agree with you. Reverse jams, windmills, putbacks. There isn't going to be a soft finish when he's close to the bucket.
Drummond with a screen on Brogdon. Caruso, the pass to Drummond. A shot, no good. Good work defensively by Horford. Boston leading by six. Smart finds Brogdon. Outside, Horford. And a great assist by Brogdon as that one goes in. Horford's got 12 points in the game.
And that's how you want to get Horford his touches, within the flow of the offense, preferably right off the catch.
Caruso looking for an opening. 52 seconds left to play in the third. Five to shoot. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. And Green gets it to go.
That's a well-timed, well-coordinated play. Comes right off the pick for the lay-in.
Here's Brogdon. He's provided them with some scoring punch and is averaging 13 points a game. He kicks it to Horford. He dishes it to White. In the corner, it's Griffin. Lock at six. Back to White. Fires the three. And it's Bradley with the rebound.
Definitely got to use the clock here and get the last shot.
But you know, this is where your patience is tested. If you shoot too quickly, you give your opponent a chance to close out the quarter.
And that's a little lack of fight at the defensive end.
Absolutely. At least on that slam, you're right. That's one way to let a team back in the game.
Yeah, defensively, your mantra at this point has to be no easy buckets.
Jaylen Brown has been leading the charge for the Boston Celtics. He ends up dropping in two from distance, making a difference from long range in this one. Right back after this break. And let's go back to a terrific pass that we're calling tonight our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And he's always been the favorite to bag this honor. These kind of feeds are his bread and butter.
This is what you need your floor general to do. Take charge, lead by example, unselfish play.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. Alex Caruso out there at DeRozan. And it's Vucevic. Then there's Dragic. And it's LaVine in at the two. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. Round kicks to Brogdon. Outside Tatum. Brown against Caruso. Shot from 12. And he gets the jumper to drop. Brown's got 10 points in just the second half.
The defense has no answer for Brown. When he's dribbling the ball, his teammates know they are in good hands.
LaVine, a screen on White. Here's Dragic. The shot, no good. And the Celtics going the other way now. Tatum with it. There's the triple. DeRozan with the rebound.
So frustrating when you can't get anything to go down as you're trying to help your team finish the job.
Vucevic, a screen on Griffin. Looking to get back on track here. That one's in there. The Boston lead is cut to just 5 points on the basket from Vucevic.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Nice ball movement by Boston. Brown against Caruso. And White kicks to Brogdon. Jacks up a three. Hits it from three-point range.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those three-point attempts.
Here's Dragic. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Outside, LaVine. Back to Dragic. Four on the clock. Here's Caruso. The rebound by Malcolm Brogdon. Celtics leading by eight. Here's the dish to White. It's stolen by Dragic. Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Outside, LaVine. Vucevic, a screen on White. 7-foot shot, and the Bulls tack on two more.
Intelligent play from Zach LaVine, getting himself the room he needs to score.
Here's White. Brown outside. Doesn't go for it. And the Bulls going the other way now. And here is Caruso. Rockets the pass to DeRozan. The three-pointer off the mark.
You know, we talk a lot about scoring efficiency. He's displaying the exact opposite.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for Boston.
Smart ball handling from them in this one. Passing around to get ahead of the defense and putting it in the hands of ready shooters.
And they've also been steady from the three-point line and doing a good job creating room for their shooters and then converting.
He misses the free throw.
You know, it's interesting. Blake has increased his shooting range, but that hasn't really carried over to the free throw line.
So for the Bulls. Patrick Williams, he's checked in for Alex Caruso. And it's Dosunmu in for Goran Dragic. Celtics also with a sub. Williams is checked in. That one misses.
And missing opportunities here to extend that lead at the free throw line this half.
Pass to DeRozan. Vucevic, a screen on Williams, down to five on the shot clock, and the basket by DeRozan.
If you can get a good screen for DeRozan on a pick and roll, more often than not, he'll convert it. Great body control.
Brogdon kicks to Griffin, outside Williams. To the inside, Tatum, and slam dunk by Tatum.
And once he gets clear off the screen, there is no stopping him.
No, not when there's a flush waiting to happen.
That's a big-time move and a big-time finish.
DeRozan finds Vucevic. A three-pointer, no good. Celtics leading by six. Griffin passes to Tatum. And he finishes nicely on the layup.
And look at the focus. I mean, Tatum's not going to allow the defense to overwhelm him. Simply keeping his eyes on the bucket there and cashing in down low.
Now here's Dosunmu. He's guarded by Brogdon. It's good. And that's now 9 points for Zach LaVine.
High offensive IQ. He makes great reads and adjustments on the fly.
And so it's Brogdon with it. He brings it up for the Boston Celtics. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. Timeout called, the Celtics. Al Horford has checked in for Boston. Marcus Smart comes in for Malcolm Brogdon. Right now, let's send it over to the sidelines and get a report from David Aldridge.
Hi, Kevin. Well, the head coach for the Celtics talked to his team during the break. He said, this is where mistakes can kill us. This is where mistakes can turn this thing completely around. Protect the basketball and make the simple play. In other words, guys, no hero ball right now.
Thank you, David. Here's Tatum, kicks it to Williams. Now here's Smart, dishes it to Brown. Horford sets a screen for Brown, and the dunk by Brown.
And you gotta love how seriously Brown takes his ability to score. He has the green light to fire from just about anywhere on the court.
Bulls trail by eight. LaVine dishes to DeRozan. And the rejection by Tatum. And he recovers it. And the basket by DeRozan. The Celtics have gone 5 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Strong work at that end of the floor. Smart deciding where to go with it. Brown finds Horford. Oh, yes, he did. 5 up and 5 down for him so far.
And no doubt, Horford's size gives him an advantage in any physical altercation on the floor. He isn't going to back down.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
That's good from DeMar DeRozan. Both free throws good from DeRozan.
Crucial that he converts those shots. They've got to keep eating away at the lead.
Round kicks to Tatum. Rebound by the Bulls. Bean passes to DeRozan. Williams, a screen on Smart. Over Smart. There's Williams, and it's sent back by Horford.
And still capable of being your defensive anchor. Horford is excellent at positioning himself to block shots. And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Here's the thing. He's a guy who will go on hot streaks for you over a number of games.
no good from Brown. 1:36 left in the fourth quarter. Tatum against DeRozan. Over Tatum. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It goes on Jason Tatum.
A sneaky move by DeRozan catches the defender leaning and draws the foul.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good, and that brings them within eight. Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one.
He needed to convert on all of those. Missed opportunities at the line are the last thing they need right now.
Horford sets a screen for Brown. It's stolen by Vucevic. LaVine feeling it out a bit. Now the pass to DeRozan. There's a minute left to play here in the fourth. Rebound by Williams. This game looks like they've got it just about wrapped up.
Yeah, just got to work that clock and take care of the ball.
Back to Tatum. Horford with a screen on DeRozan. Six on the shot clock. And there's Horford. That's good on the assist by Tatum. Horford's got the lead up to 10 now for Boston.
And it's just competing. You know, giving your best when it matters most.
It's called killer instinct. It's one thing to be close at the end. It's another to finish.
There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. Tatum's shot is off.
Guys, let's just go ahead and call this one. It's over.
They couldn't make enough plays when it mattered. Interesting game, though, in terms of some of the matchups.
Brown outside. And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. And in the win, a comfortable win in what was, I think, gee, a pretty hostile environment.
It really was. You know, it's never going to be easy on the road, but they didn't have too many problems with that tonight.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Jalen. On a real roll right now, how much pride do you take in the win streak?
Let's just keep it going. Just keep playing basketball, keep having fun, keep smiling, and it's fun when you win.
That alternative's not very good, so you want to keep winning. Thanks again, man. Back to you.
David, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up. Now for Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA here on 2K Sports. Now let's check out our New Balance Player of the Game, Jaylen Brown.